Hi, this land is mystery. That's Bailey. Wanna go? Bailey and I are here on San Juan Island, Washington, doing a house sit. Well, I'm doing a house sit. This is not my rig. I'm purchasing my next rig middle to the end of February, here in Washington. Then I have a house sit for 6 weeks after that, so I hope to build out my new rig. I've never spent more than $4,000 on a vehicle before. Looks like I'm probably going to be spending about $5,000 in that range on this vehicle, so not too bad. Bailey's an Australian Labradoodle, but he understands me pretty well. So we are itching for a hike today, and we're going to take you along with us. Also, I reached 1,000 subscribers on this channel. I'm no Mr. Beast, but YouTube does send you a certificate when you get 1,000 subscribers. Now, it's not the diamond encrusted platinum plaque that, you know, people with millions of subscribers have, but it's kind of cool. Let me grab it here. So they just send you this in the mail, and you can see there it says, congratulations, 1,000 subscribers, and the name of the channel. It's pretty cool. I'll probably put this in my new rig when I buy it and build it out. Might laminate it, put it someplace, but yeah, I appreciate that. Thanks, YouTube. My final semester at university, this is a very long time ago, I worked at a presidential research center, and the head librarian there was probably not much older than I am now. She's probably early 40s or something. Being that it was the last semester of my university career, she asked me, so Mystery, what are you gonna be doing? Come on, Bailey, let's go. So she asked me, what are you gonna do after graduation? And I said, I'll probably work in politics and then go to law school. Then I told her, but you know, I honestly have no idea what I'm doing with my life. She said, well, you know, when you get to be my age, those feelings don't go away. So I think I just smiled politely and nodded. Oh, okay, is that so, old lady? Now that I'm almost her age, I can confirm that what she said is absolutely true, that those feelings of uncertainty don't go away. But I think if you harness that, and if you treat it the right way and you have the right attitude about it, it doesn't have to be a negative thing. So in that spirit, I took a bunch of personality tests.
Oh my gosh, I love your personality. Thank you so much.
Want to see the results? So the first test I took was the Myers-Briggs. You've probably heard of this one before. It's the 16 different personality types. I've taken this test multiple times, and I think each time I've gotten INTJ, which is the architect.
You know, the stupidest guy in my fraternity became an architect after he flunked out of dental school.
Then you can go to a website where it shows you a bunch of different architects you may know, some real, some fictitious. The I, of course, in INTJ is introvert. Of course I'm an introvert. Everyone from the Midwest is an introvert. There are Midwestern extroverts, but put them in like downtown Philadelphia or something, they're introverts. You know how you tell the difference between an introvert and an extrovert in the Midwest? Well, an introvert from the Midwest looks at his shoes when he talks to you, and an extrovert from the Midwest looks at your shoes when he talks to you.
To the top.
So for my next trick, I took a test called the Enneagram. I am a 5, same as Einstein and Bill Gates. I don't know who the guy is next to Einstein. I think he's either really famous or not at all famous. I don't think there's any in between with that guy. I don't know who the guy to the right of him is either. Looks like Emily Dickinson, maybe Edith Wharton. I have no idea what Edith Wharton looks like, But anytime I hear the name Edith Wharton, this person is exactly what I imagine. So it's probably Emily Dickinson. Then you've got Marlon Brando, a young Marlon Brando, of course, Bill Gates, and Vincent Van Gee. So five is called the investigator. I'm the investigator. And here is what they say about that personality type. As life's philosophers, the investigator seeks out patterns and connections between the grand mysteries, no relation, of the essence of life. They're sponges for knowledge and trek intellectually through new untouched roads with an open mind. Yeah, whatever, I guess. Sounds good to me. Bailey and I are trekking intellectually right now. And we're glad you're here for the journey. So the next test I took was that right brain, left brain. It's probably one you've taken in the past, or at least some form of it. Left brain is the logical, mathematical, organized reasoning, all those things that I lack. Right brain is the creative, artistic, whimsical, paint your toenails 37 different colors, but forget to brush your hair. That's the right brain. Any guesses as to which side your old buddy here scored? That's right, right brain. 70% right brain. Now, I think a lot of people would look at that result and say, oh, Mr. E, you're a creative. Yeah, but I think what we strive for, what I strive for, is balance. More balance, not a perfect balance. Nobody's ever gonna be that. I think it surprises a lot of people, especially in professional settings, because my personality is very dry. My humor is extremely dry. And, you know, my style of dress is accountant casual. It manifests in different ways. So you give me a paintbrush and a canvas, I have no idea what to do with that. But you give me a pen and paper, or you give me a phone camera, you know, I can make things happen. So creativity is a very, very broad category. It's like saying, I like Asian food. Okay. Like a third of people in the world live in Asia, you know, so pretty broad categories of cuisine. And I think the same is true of creativity. So a really interesting test that I took is called Principles U. And I took it at the company I used to work for. And after you take the test, it gives you this archipelago. You get your main trait, and followed by your main trait, there are two secondary and tertiary traits, I guess you would call them. Most people are pretty balanced. So they're on one island, and another island, and a third island. Well, I'm imbalanced because my main trait was individualist, followed by artisan and inventor. So I'm not all over the map. I am instead out of balance, and all the little voices in my head feel like we're just about to tip over. I took one more test. It's called the Love Calculator. See how mystery does on the old love calculator. Not too good. Not too good. Hey, look at the camera. You think we're too far away? Probably. Hi. It's getting nasty out here. I had this whole thing planned. I don't know why I'm so far away from the camera. Question is, where does this channel go from here? Yeah, it's windy and rainy. Let's move. Let's move to a quieter locale, B. How's my hair looking? How's the hair? Bailey, how's my hair looking? Hi. Where does the channel go from here? I don't know. If I had to guess, I'd probably say that I will still be here on YouTube in some form. Instead of putting out a new video every 3 or 4 weeks, I might do it every month or two or three. I just don't know. I think mostly what I want to do is create the types of videos that I would like to watch. Those are the types of videos I enjoy making. Those are the types of videos you can probably count on seeing in year three. But again, I don't know the frequency with which I'll be posting here on YouTube. We'll just have to see what life brings and what direction I choose to go with this little old channel here in the corner of YouTube. So thanks for watching. If you've been around for year two, or if you've been around for both years, appreciate you being here, and I'll see you in the world.
Buy a personality.